creating multipads. This task shows you how to extrude multiple profiles belonging to a same sketch using different length values. The multipad capability lets you do this at one time. At the end of the task, you will see how to edit the resulting feature. First, open Multipad CAD part document. You can download the file from the link given in the description. Click Multipad. Select sketch 1 that contains the profiles to be extruded. Note that all profiles must be closed and must not intersect. In case a profile would be open, the application would not take it into account. The Multipad definition dialog box appears and the profiles are highlighted in green. For each of them, you can drag associated manipulators to define the extrusion value. The red arrow normal to the sketch indicates the proposed extrusion direction. To reverse it, you just need to click it. The Multipad definition dialog box displays the number of domains to be extruded. In our example, the application has detected 7 extrusions to perform as indicated in the domains section. Select extrusion domain 1 from the dialog box. Extrusion domain 1 now appears in blue in the geometry area. Specify the length by entering a value. For example, enter 10 mm. You need to repeat the operation for each extrusion domain by entering the value of your choice. For example, select extrusion domain 2 and extrusion domain 7 and enter 30 mm and 40 mm respectively. For complex sketches, the preview button proves to be quite useful. Note that you can multi-select extrusion domains from the list before defining a common length. Multi-select extrusion domain 3, extrusion domain 4, extrusion domain 5 and extrusion domain 6, then enter 50 as the common length value. One length value is now defined for each profile of sketch 1. Click More to expand the dialog box. In the second limit field, you can specify a length value for the opposite direction. For example, select extrusion domain 1 and enter 40 mm in the length field. Note that the thickness section displays the sum of the two lengths. Extrusion domain 1's total length is 50 mm. Unchecking the normal to sketch option lets you specify a new extrusion direction. Just select the geometry of your choice to use it as a reference. Click OK to create the multipad. The multipad is added to the specification tree. Editing a multipad. The rest of the scenario shows you what happens when adding an extrusion domain and deleting an extrusion domain. Double-click Sketch 1 to edit it. Sketch a rectangle outside extrusion domain 1. Close the sketcher. A warning message informs you that the application has detected that the initial geometry has been modified. Close the window. Double-click Multipad 1. The feature definition error window displays, providing the details of the modification. Click OK to close the window. The multi-pocket definition dialog box reappears. The new extrusion domain 8 is indicated. Select it and define the value of your choice. Click OK to confirm. Multipad 1 is now composed of 8 pads. Double-click Sketch 1 and add a circle inside Extrusion Domain 2. Exit the sketcher. A warning message informs you that the application has detected that the initial sketch has been modified. Close this window. Double-click Multipad 1. The feature definition error window displays, providing the details of the modification. When sketching a profile inside an existing extrusion domain, the application deletes that existing domain and replaces it with a new one. This is why the message window displays one extrusion domain deleted, extrusion domain 0.2, and two extrusion domains created, extrusion domain 9, which replaces extrusion domain 2 and extrusion domain 10. Click OK to close the window. The Multipad definition dialog box reappears. Extrusion domain 2 is no more displayed. On the contrary, two new extrusion domains, extrusion domain 9 and extrusion domain 10, are indicated with 0 mm as the default thickness. Select extrusion domain 9 if not already done and define 30 mm as the length value. Select extrusion domain 10, that is the circle, and define 60 mm as the length value. Click OK to confirm. Multipad 0.1 is now composed of 9 pads. Double-click Sketch 1 and delete Extrusion Domain 6. Close Sketcher. The application has detected that the initial sketch has been modified. To tackle the problem, you can either edit or delete in Multipad 1, or you can edit or delete Extrusion Domain 6. Make sure that Multipad 1 is selected and click the Edit button. The feature definition error window displays, providing the details of the modification. Click OK to close the window. The Multipad definition dialog box reappears. Only 8 extrusion domains are indicated in the domains category. Click OK to confirm. The new Multipad feature is composed of 8 pads. You can find out more about sketch-based commands in the playlist. Explore other workbenches or practice your modeling with exercise videos in the channel.